Sometimes miracles happen in the most unlikely places, like a war zone, for example.
Sergeant Craig Grossi served as a Marine for 8 years. 2010, he found himself fighting for our country and his life in a remote and extremely dangerous part of Afghanistan.
After a fierce battle, the dust settled, and Craig saw a stray dog alone in the debris. Take a look.
I came across him in this little compound we were held up in, and something just in me just told me to go over and approach this little dog. As soon as I got close to him, he started wagging his tail. He was hot, hungry, covered in bugs, and had absolutely no reason to show me any kind of trust or love, but he did it right away. From that moment on, he followed me everywhere I went.
It was time for Craig to leave the war zone and go back to base. But he knew in his heart he could never leave Fred. So he snuck him into a duffel bag and brought him along. It was risky. If he got caught with a dog, he could go to jail and Fred could be euthanized. But he went for it and came up with a plan to get Fred home to his family in the U.S. until he returned. 4 months later, they were reunited and haven't been apart since.
Marine Sergeant Craig Grossi and his best friend Fred are here. Come on out, guys.
Oh, yeah.
Hi, Fred.
Lead the way.
Hey,
what's up?
Hi, Fred.
Nice to meet you.
Hey, yeah,
you
Fred. Too.
Thank you for your service.
Oh, of course. Where are you gonna go, buddy?
Hi, Fred.
Where do you wanna go?
Here? Come here. You love
How
a good crowd.
That is awesome.
You're
Fred,
come on. Couch guy.
First of all, thank you so much for
your
service.
Oh,
thank
of course.
You.
Of course.
Thank you.
Where are you going? Where do you wanna go?
Get him.
He sees Nora and Ruby over there.
Oh.
Yeah.
Now, there are a lot of stray dogs in Afghanistan.
Yeah, and it's not a cultural thing. I mean, Afghans love their animals, and they take great care of the ones that they can, you know, and unfortunately, the dogs kind of end up falling to the side.
But there was something special about Fred.
Oh, yeah, definitely. We were in Sangin, and after that first week, really, you know, things kind of calmed down, and the Taliban were trying to run us off this little hill we were on. And I caught a glimpse of him every once in a while. I'd kind of be bopping around the battlefield. I'd be cleaning my gun or getting some water, and I'd see him, and he always kind of made me smile. And when things calmed down, I was like, I got to check him out. I got to at least give it a shot. And I walked over towards him with a piece of beef jerky and the rest.
Best friends.
Yeah.
I'm gonna hang out with this guy from now on.
We travel the country now and we share our story in lots of different places, a lot of schools and a lot of events and stuff. And those first moments are one of my favorite things to talk about because it's really the kind of the message that Fred has for me and for all of us, you know. And those first moments, he kind of had a choice, and I had my own expectations. Like he's gonna growl at me, he's gonna snap at me, he's gonna raise his hair, you know, and try to get me to leave him alone. That's what you would expect. And as I got closer and I heard this little kind of thud, thump, 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 thump coming from him, and I looked up and he was wagging his tail.
That tail was going.
And we talk about, you know, bringing dogs to work all the time.
Yeah,
and it helped with morale when
Big
you
time.
Had Fred on the battlefield in Afghanistan.
Yeah.
What was that like for you psychologically?
It was huge for a lot of us. Not just me. I mean, the Marines that I was with, most of these guys have been deployed way more than me. They've seen their share of street dogs, but they too, we're not immune to Fred, you know, and we all, I think, whether it was 5 minutes or 5 seconds, you just took a second to hang with Fred.
Right.
He kind of stabilized us, and he brought us almost a little piece of home.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, a little slice of kind of what we were, fighting for over there, kind of what we were, you know, we were all kind of representing.
It's amazing the power of a pet.
Yeah, it really, it is,
Definitely. You were injured.
So I snuck Fred out when we left Sangin for the first time. We were there for about a month. And I left it up to him. I was like, if he follows me to the helicopter, you know, we'll do what we got to do. And me and my buddy Mark stuffed him in a duffel bag and ran him up the back of the helicopter. He went on a helicopter ride before he went on a car ride.
Oh,
not a lot
God.
Of dogs can say that. And so we got him back to base, and we were only there for 2 weeks, and we were going right back out into Sangin. And so I just found a place to kind of hide him. I found these guys that worked for DHL, and they took care of him on their compound, and they took him in, and they loved him. And I went back out on another mission and was there for about a week back in Sangin, and I got a little too close to a rocket blast. It was an anti-tank rocket landed right behind me and blew up a little wall was the only thing that kind of saved me. And I got a good bump on the head, and they, you know, they take that pretty seriously, so they had to take me out. And I woke up kind of in the hospital back at Leatherneck where Fred was.
Right.
And all my only thought was, I got to get Fred the rest of the way home. Yeah, it was my window. It was my kind of my chance.
Right.
Again, just kind of making the best out of a bad situation. And I got the, got him on a plane.
This is your dad?
And that's my dad, yeah.
Did he didn't want to give Fred up when he came back?
No, he did. He was ready. I think.
Okay.
Yeah.
So we talked about how he influenced your life in Afghanistan and your fellow soldiers, but how about when you got home, how did he change your life?
Yeah, that's when it really got interesting. I got home and I got out, and within 5-6 months, I was in a suit and tie working in a cubicle for the government,
wow.
You know, and I had a new truck and a new apartment, and I was doing my best to put Afghanistan and my time there behind me, but I was starting to figure out it doesn't really work that way,
right.
You know, and I was very unhappy. I was drinking too much, and there was some problems with just my own kind of idea of what my life was supposed to look like, and
uh-huh.
I started walking Fred around D.C. and started.
Right. And, there you go.
Yeah.
And little by little, I started sharing our story with people at the dog park, people on the streets of D.C. when I lived in the city. And the more I told it to people, the more I realized I loved telling it, and the more I realized people loved hearing it.
Yeah.
And I left the government after about 2 years, and I got into Georgetown University, and they really embraced a lot of veterans there. I found out that it's one of the best schools in the country for veterans.
Mm-hmm. Great.
And I started writing papers and stuff for school, and I started to realize, hey, I really like writing. I really love this. And so on the weekends, I'd take Fred on a hike, you know, around Virginia or something, and I'd bring a legal pad, and I would just fill it by the campfire at night, you know, and the more I wrote, the better I felt, and the more I realized.
Yeah, it's cathartic.
It was kind of my duty to share this story, because there's so many ways that it could have gone really wrong for both of us, and the fact that it didn't, you know, it was kind of our place. It's kind of our job to do our part and share.
That's your book.
Yeah,
about.
Yeah.
Tell us about your book.
Yeah, the book. Yeah. The book is another way that Fred has kind of saved me through writing and through our book and through our events. We travel all over the country, and I speak at schools and libraries and all, you know, anywhere people will have us. And we're really, you know, doing our part to kind of change the world and show people that we. Yeah. Thank you. We're a lot tougher than we think. We can always find a reason. We can always dig deep and find a reason to wag our tails. And
absolutely.
Yeah, right, buddy?
Or tushy strap.
Yeah, yeah.
Thank you, Craig and Fred. Thank you again for your
Thank you, guys.
Thank you so much.
It's great to be here.